linebackers and blocks, the linemen, same thing with them. And they also started doing different looks on defense as well than what we had practiced. So that kind of played a huge role in the way the linemen were blocking as well.
Knowing what you guys have coming ahead with the teams you have coming ahead, that third quarter, how important do you feel that was to kind of prove what you can be and who you are?
I mean, it was pretty known that we had to, you know, in a way blow these guys out. They came playing us with a chip on their shoulder, so they felt like they had something to prove that, you know, they could have got recruited to a better school as well. So they came out punching us in the mouth, and we responded after halftime. Well, the run set that up because a lot of them were play action plays. So, you know, them selling out on the run, you know, leaves a bunch of gaps for the receivers downfield. And Danny did a great job giving the ball. The receivers did a great job looking it in and catching it. And everything just went efficient. It was bad. Like, we all looked bad as a whole. And, you know, he was just saying we got to pick them up. We got to give them that energy. We got to pick it up. We got to be a leader out there.
Early this season, you were talking about how you prepared like a starter. Now your role has basically been, you've been the workhorse the last few weeks. How has that changed your mentality, or is it just staying the same?
It didn't really change my mentality because, you know, since I've been here since last year, you know, every time I'm put in, I gotta play as a starter. Because, you know, you gotta realize who you're backing up, and you can't let, you know, opponents know that you're, you know, a weakling or, you know, a slouch. So just got to come out ready, and our coaches do a great job preparing all the running backs to be ready because you never know when you're going to be called upon. So
talk about the adjustments a little bit. Was it more X's and O's, or was it more of a mentality thing?
It was more of a mentality thing. You know, we had some stupid penalties in the beginning. Like I said earlier, you know, missing blocks all around. And we all just got to clicking after halftime. Coach Ainsley McCain gave us a little pep talk. We just all came out clicking.
Can you talk about the development of a guy like DJ Chark, who everybody had heard about as in practice, and the great things he was doing, and now you see over the last few weeks he's really maturing?
I'm happy for DJ. You can see it at practice that he really wants it. You know, one of the faster guys on the team. You know, he can catch, as well as Malachi and Traven. You know, just seeing a guy like DJ just come out and be a spark player. You know, we need everybody. So that's why we tell everybody, your time coming. Don't get discouraged when you don't play as well as you want to or how much you want to. Just when your name called on, you got to do what you got to do.
Would you say that was a perfect second half?
I wouldn't say perfect because nothing's ever perfect in a football game. You're going to have mistakes here and now. It's just how you respond. You know, I would say we responded perfectly.
What do you think of the hole you had on the long touchdown run?
I think the lineman did a great job of setting it up for me. And the rest is history because I'm not going to get caught from behind.